Thank you for joining us today and learning more about the Data Cookbook by iData, the leading data governance solution for institutions of higher education. This is part of a series of videos providing details on the benefits and features of the Data Cookbook. We hope you find them helpful. So it starts out, the Data Cookbook at its core has, central to all of the Data Cookbook, has a workflow engine that is meant to manage, handle, and help your governance processes, right? You can customize this workflow for each different type of thing to match your business needs. And it would be providing notifications and dealing with change management as we go through. So I'll provide examples as I go through some of the other features, but that's at the core of everything in the Data Cookbook. The next layer around that are your definitions. And this is a very fundamental, this is a thing that a lot of people start with. And these are your definitions of your data that you're using, and they provide a business explanation as well as a technical explanation, removing the confusion and questions about how and where that data is being pulled. And your technical resources can now centrally share their coding practices to standardize how that data is being calculated. And data stewards or functional experts would be involved in the workflow to review and approve any content that's being added or updated. And a lot of this is based on your functional structure. So you might have different, you know, admissions has different people reviewing it than financial aid and so on. So these definitions house your functional and technical information about your business terminology. The next layer around that are specifications. Now, these would be your reports and your dashboards or your ETL processes. And users are provided here with a description of the reports they're looking at. And you can provide that from your own reporting tool. The cookbook then becomes your tool for collecting these requirements when people are requesting reports and getting agreement before you build the reports in the dashboard. So you use the Data Cookbook to establish the requirements, get agreement, everybody can see that before you go and build. And then the cookbook helps warn you when changes to definitions are done and warns you which areas and which reports might be affected because they're using those same definitions. So you start to get some change management built in there. Right. Now, we also have with the Data Cookbook have established a community. And this is a fabulous growing community. I'll give you the URL at the end of the presentation. You can go to community.datacookbook.com. And it provides it's a resource that has definitions and specifications from a variety of national and state level agencies, as well as some of our own clients that are sharing in that community. And this is a great help when writing new definitions. You can be writing them and pulling in examples from the community, or you can get a jump start on your definitions by utilizing a whole set of definitions, for example, copying in iPad's definitions. So the Data Cookbook community is a place where you can share your content and browse the content of other clients and organizations. And we actively curate some of that content. We make it visible to you as you create your new definitions. Another layer that we are just, the recent addition is the Enterprise edition of the Data Cookbook. And these next few things are part of that. We have recently added the capability to do technical metadata. And that means at the lowest level, bringing in information about the tables and columns, procedures and views of an entire database of each of your different databases that you're tracking in the Data Cookbook. This would expose those tables, columns, and views and their descriptions in the Data Cookbook. And then technical users can start to use those elements to build on the definitions, right? So we can now go into a definition and specify which columns and tables are being utilized. And you can start to document with a specification, the lineage from the data, you know, the columns and tables in one data system as they go to the tables and columns in another data system. For instance, if you've got data marts that are being populated or a data warehouse being built out. With this technical metadata that's been loaded in from your data system, we also provide data management connectors with our integration component, our iData Hub, and those data management connectors can monitor this technical metadata in your system, monitor it for changes, and then initiate workflows in the Data Cookbook to take care of those changes. That way, if a column changes, then we now get alerted in the cookbook to the definitions that might have been infected. And then, of course, if we're working on a definition, we get alerted about the specifications that might be affected. So the cookbook becomes this central change management mechanism for keeping track of the changes. Right? And the next layer around that are collections, templates, and ETL processes. So we have the specifications out there, and those are those provide a solution for basic reports and documenting simply relationship of the spec to the definitions. We're now adding in new capabilities and expanded specifications in the form of templates. So we are providing a template to track ETL documentation. And in that one, you'd be able to have a graphical tool to track where the metadata goes, you know, source to target and what processes go on in between it. We are providing a new template to help you mock up the display layout of a report. So we're providing several templates there in specifications to give you more specific targeted solutions in specifications. And we also built a new item called collections. And a collection is the full documentation regarding either maybe a large fact book or a complicated multi-part report or a set of dashboards. So a collection is really a way to document a full set of specifications that operate as a whole. So you can document that complex relationship of a large set of reports that get pulled together into a publication or that are tightly coupled with each other. All right, so collections is a new capability there. And then the last ring here is the data quality and reference data. And this really allows you to provide users with an understanding of how reliable the data is based on assessments of rules so that the users can be more confident in their use of that data to support their decisions, right? Users can look at reference data, which is the reference data being your lists of valid majors, lists of valid student types, and things like that. Users can be made aware of changes in that reference data that may impact their business processes or reports. And they get insight into any existing quality issues that have been documented, right? And have the users have the ability to report additional issues so that everyone is aware if there are any current issues going on with certain pieces of data or, you know, any reports of issues, right? And our data management connectors come into play again here with the iData Hub and our integration. With those data management connectors, we can automate the testing of your quality rules against your database and initiate issues when we find that's failed beyond a certain threshold, right? We also have data management connectors that can be checking your reference data, so your valid list of majors. How many, you know, what are the major codes that we have? We'd have them in the data cookbook, and it can go confirm that they're still the same in your system. And if they're different, then we can initiate a workflow in the data cookbook to resolve that difference. Right, because if somebody added a new code, we might have many definitions that have been impacted by that, and therefore many specifications and so on. So what we're trying to do there is the more you're able to quantify and document the quality and the reference data and the technical metadata, the more that the cookbook can help actually with managing change over time. So that's the introduction to the features.
Thanks again for joining us today and hearing about the Data Cookbook. Please watch our other videos located at datacookbook.com/videos. You can also learn about the Data Cookbook at datacookbook.com/tour. And remember, there is a community focused on data management at community.datacookbook.com, where you can access information regarding data governance, reporting, and data definitions. Have a great day.